about the Babkin reflex that is the basic driver of what is we call teeth grinding, clenching, you know, to all the different levels that might happen to be. So basically, this is what's called a primitive or primary childhood reflex that normally will be found in the first few months of infancy. It's very important for very many things. It really, really starts once the child has gotten to be a little bit older, so 2 months. It really kicks in as far as what we would consider like a systems integration, okay? So eye-hand coordination, first eye coordination, bifocal coordination of the eyes, the eye-hand coordination, and obviously the precision of the movement coming into the mouth with the hand, okay? And as we said, these are neurosensory motor programs. So what actually happens in infancy is that the brain, instead of waiting for a stimulus in order to activate a response, it's going to self-activate. So it sends signals down into the nerves in the center of the palm. Some people say out here, but basically in this area of the palm, and self-tickles. So children feel the desire to want to have something in their hands, okay? And that instigates a whole series of movements. So the child will locate something, go to grab it, come up, open their mouths, bite this object or whatever it happens to be, bite it. They'll let go as well and chew. And then they'll grab it and keep playing with it and let it go. It could be their hand. They try to put their hand in their mouth. At certain ages, kids are doing, you know, putting everything into their mouths. Okay. And this is actually an incredibly important aspect of our posture. And when it first starts activating, we're actually laying down, belly down. And so this is so important for head writing, lifting the head, okay, which is also activating our Perez reflex, but activating shoulder posture, okay, and then going to reach for something, creating that kind of core strength from the belly down perspective, and getting that into the mouth. So from a postural point of view, all of this has to work together in order to make that movement complete. Okay, and that is an incredibly important concept of this integration of these childhood reflexes. Mainstream neurology says that these reflexes disappear, okay? That is not true. They become integrated into our bodies, okay? And what does that mean, integrated? It means that it doesn't any longer self-activate, okay? So as infants, this just happens all by itself. The nervous system is self-activating, sending these stimulus in order to force the body to self-activate, to perform these different movements that form our whole posture, okay? Most of everything happens already in the embryo, but there's some really important ones that happen after. The Perez, okay, the Gallant reflex, the leg cross flexion extension reflex, head writing, okay? These kind of come after birth. And one of them also is this palmo-mental reflex, okay, or Babkin reflex. And so looking at that postural stability that has to be there, okay, that all that muscle movement and positioning and eye coordination, hand coordination, is all connected into one piece in our neurology in that program, okay? And so that program is a pretty important program when we're thinking about this kind of core stability, blocking the shoulders back, and free arm movement, right? And so we're not blocked into some kind of movement that our arms are free, okay? They can work independent of each other. And so as we're doing this as little children, becomes, at a certain point, so well understood, becomes so well performed that they don't really understand yet why, but or how, but somehow it stops self-activating. Again, it doesn't mean that it disappears, okay? What it means is that it stops self-activating, or it should at least, okay? Now, this is what is happening with the people who are suffering from bruxism, is that it didn't stop self-activating. And so they're going around clenching, their hands, all of this tension that's being created, okay, in this whole system is being self-activated. And in a certain sense, in that self-activation, there's a certain part of our understanding, self-perception, that is trying to counteract this all of this instinctual desire to put things in our mouths, okay, from pens to fingernails to, okay, so basically also some certain things will be getting rigid and tight and just try and stop this uncontrolled and absolutely in some cases undesired activation of the system. So what we're going to do is through the app, we're going, and through these neurological movements, we're going to move you through the evolution of the human body up until that point and a little bit further, okay? So sometimes the palmo-mental reflex didn't integrate because there was something else that wasn't integrated, okay? Because it is a higher level neuroprogram, then there could be another neuroprogram below that when we were in our mother's wombs that could maybe wasn't integrated. So we start from level one, which is basically a self-massage, a self-care, 8-minute painkiller. It is exactly what it says. It will take away your pain in just those few 8 minutes, okay? Just follow it, just trust it. It really, really works, okay? And it's free too, so please, by all means, go for it. And level two is when we start to go through the amphibian, the fish reflexes, the reptilian reflexes, getting our bodies ready to go back into the higher reflexes after birth that come in level two. In level two, I teach you the basics, some other higher level reflexes, as well as the how to best integrate the palmo-mental reflex, okay? And so I've done this with a lot of different, I've done this with little children where the parents will be putting food out on a face cloth on the floor, and they'll put it in there because they're grinding the 4 or 5 teeth like my son did as soon as they come. And so even these young children, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 years old, by playing a little game, we can integrate this reflex as well, even by stimulating sort of some of the sensory points that are important ends of activating these neurological responses, okay? So that's what the app is all about, is we're going to retrain, we're going to make sure that all of these very important basic postural building blocks are known, are activated, are able to be done, and able to be done well, okay? And so that's one of the reasons you don't want to go too fast through the program in the beginning, level one, is because you want to give these a little bit of time in order to sink in and to really integrate into your neurology. So in the beginning, we call it, you know, put the Band-Aid on the sore. So do the 8-minute painkiller once or even twice or three times a day if you have to. You'll find immediate relief, and depending upon the level of and gravity of your situation, you'll find that it will last longer and longer and longer. So please do that. Take your time on level one. Once you get to level two, I can tell you, you're probably already feeling like a completely different person already, but do not stop the training because you haven't integrated the reflex yet. So take your time and do an extra 3-4 weeks of level 2 in order to truly get this into your neurology and get it out of your system, okay? We want to integrate this reflex as well as we can, not just clean up the basics behind it. That can do a lot for sure, but we want to actually be certain that all of the different pieces of that puzzle are working the way the neurological program wants it to work, okay? Which will then calm it all down, because now it's not looking to fix anything anymore. It's going to be thinking everything is perfect, everything is online, and you're just going to feel an amazing sense of relaxation, tranquility, and lack of stress in your life like you've never had before, okay? Little interesting note, I found this bruxism in a jiu-jitsu person, and he didn't know that he had it, and he didn't know he was clenching, he didn't know what bruxism was, he didn't know that it could be a problem, and he was having all kinds of neck pain. Obviously doing jiu-jitsu you have neck pain for a lot of different reasons, but he was having a lot of different neck pain. I was noticing lots of jaw tension as well, so that's why I asked him, do you clench? He said yes. I said, okay, let's do this integration. We did 3-4 treatments, and at 37 years old, only a blue belt, he went on to win the Pan Ams against 20-year-olds and 24-year-olds, which is unheard, like it's just mind-blowing. He blew the top off of the Pan Ams. And I'm not saying that it was only due to this. However, for sure, when you can release the body of that kind of postural stress, especially that postural stress for the back and that core shoulder strength, you know he's going to be able to perform at his true top level. And so I only hope for the rest of you that will give you a better posture in whatever you're doing, whether it's driving your trucks, cars, whether you're working on a job as a carpenter, or whether you're in the office, or whether you're ironing, or it doesn't matter. This will give you so much relief in your shoulder, neck, arms. And so that's where all of these headache relief and migraine relief comes from. So I wish you the best of luck. Please do leave notes below, and also keep your eye out for the little promo codes that we'll be sending out with some discounts on the app. Okay, so take care, you guys, and please, tons of questions, tons of comments, and let's get this thing going. Okay? Good luck.